Okay, let's go in Mumbo's hut over here, see what the next animal transformation is. So, what you got for us, Mumbo? Let's see, is there anything? Here's some notes right over here. Okay. You need 20 Mumbo tokens for this. Anything up here? There's just a goat feather. Okay, so what you got for us, Mumbo? That's cost 20 tokens. Is it a kill? Is it one of them tombstones? No, we're a pumpkin. Ah, Mumbo proud of pumpkin spell. Make good soup. We better get the hell out of here because Mumbo's getting hungry. But anyways, we're the pumpkin. And the only good use for the pumpkin, much like the other transformations, like the termite and the walrus, you can go through small gaps that Banjo-Kazooie couldn't do before. So we can actually go through here. Look at this Mumbo token. I need 25 to finish the game. Right here for the final. Oh, dang it! I'm in the grass. Okay, let's try it again. I kind of failed right there. Okay, now go up here. Okay, let's go through here. I think this one's this is the one with the broken floor that has the empty honeycomb. Got that. And now let's actually go to the bathroom because Banjo is small enough to go through Lago. I don't know why. Don't know why would you go in there where Grunty uses the bathroom. Kind of nasty. Okay, well, let's go in. Happy landings, little one. Yeah, happy landings, my hand in. So we're in the freaking toilet here. It's Lago. Jiggy. And we have the Grilly Chompus. Let me see if I need any gold feathers here. Yeah. And that's it. Let's leave. Okay. I can't believe you went in there. Now wash your hands, Fifty Bear. You want me to wash my hands? Look, guess what? I'm washing my freaking hands. See, look at this. I'm washing my hands, getting cleaned. Oh, wait a minute. Pumpkin Banjo doesn't have any hands. Okay. It's not as spectacular as my old project when I did it. But anyways, go through this little opening. Alright, I gotta go on back on top of the house. I'm screwing up. Now I gotta go back on top of the house and go through there, because there is a Jiggy in there. And that's the only way you can get it. Because the pumpkin doesn't jump that high. Let's be very careful here. Something wrong with my control stick. That's kind of... Nah, I guess that's the problem with N64 control sticks. They tend to wear as you play. You know what I mean. They tend to wear over time. But anyways, go through there, Jiggy, and some notes. Just got one more Jiggy to get, and the rest of the notes is where the final Jiggy is. Ah! No! Get away from me! Okay, well, there's some more notes over here. Over at this, well. Now, I think this is, bad water, like poisonous water or something. That Banjo and Kazooie can't go in, but the pumpkin can. Okay, so now let's go in the well here. And should land in a bucket right here. And that is the last Jiggy and the last notes. And make sure... I mean, you can actually do this with Banjo and Kazooie, but the pumpkin makes it better because you don't have to... Because it makes things a little bit easier than you would if you were Banjo. Anyways, that's the rest of it. Ouch! That hurt. Okay, let me check the totals real quick. Yep, Mad Monster Mansion, fully complete. 26 minutes, a little higher than I would normally do it. I just kept on screwing up at that one part. And trying to figure out how many tombstones there were. And I almost got hit by that guy. Well, it's time to say goodbye to this world. Even though it's my favorite world in the game, we got a mission to complete. Wait a minute. Saw a Momo token over here. Let me get it. Got it. Ah! No! Get away from me. Okay, so let's leave. I want to stay as the pumpkin because we need it. There we go. Man, get away from me. Alrighty, remember that gate we busted in a couple videos ago? Well, we can actually go through here. Go into this house over here. Only accessible by a pumpkin. Let's see what's in here. I know that sleeping noise. Hey, it's Mumbo! It might give us a special transformation. So, the transformation for Grunty's lair is... Yeah, we just turned back to Banjo. We need to be Banjo anyway because we need to peek buster this coffin here. And you lucky. Ah! Okay, so bust open this coffin. You get a water level switch. What that does, that will make the water rise up to the first level. Over at World 8. So now we can actually open it, but still not high enough when we need to. But let's change back to the pumpkin. Because there's one more thing. Well, plus we need to get out of here anyway, so that's the only way we can get out. Pumpkin making Mumbo hungry. Me get pot ready. Let's leave before he has a chance to warm his pot up and eat us. That'd be horrible. Watch out for the gruntling. Still trying to get us, but he's like, out of heck with it. Alright, we're done here. Excuse me. Sorry for the yawn. Been a big day. Well, it's still, it's actually Wednesday night when I'm recording this. Okay. Remember that little path we saw before we entered the world here? We can now actually go through here. Plus, there's a little opening right over here. Be very, very careful, because if you fall off and you fall into that lava, it's sudden death. So, be very, very careful. And there's Brintilda. Ah, made it. There we go. Now let's talk to Brintilda and see what's up. Okay, the Velvet Grantail's bedroom has smelly socks hanging from the ceiling. Okay, smelly socks. Okay, she has a Veronica plant growing in a pot beside her bed. Oh, man. That sounds kind of horrible anyway. Okay, you'd be sick if you saw her enormous spotty purple undies. Okay. So we got sweaty socks, a Veronica plant, and what was the last one? Oh, spotty purple. But anyways, go through this little opening. And we found Cheetah Spellbook once again. Geo, Bear, and Bird have found once more. Another spell they get. If one more page I see you turn, then Grunty Shell Cheeto Burn. Nasty witches, so cold I shall tell. Enter Red Feathers on Sandcastle Floor in Treasure Trove Cove. So yeah, we found Cheeto again, and he'll give us another cheat, this time for Red Feathers. But we're not going to enter it just yet. But, let's make this quick. Grunty, I don't think Tootie's fine with you. Because you're trying to switch bodies with her, or switch, or do that little machine thing that makes her ugly and makes you beautiful. That's what you're trying to do. So, even if you go home, you just told a big fat lie, so. Alrighty, there we go. I could have just made it quicker and just jumped down in there and just died, but let's see if I can actually make it with no death, like a no death run. Yeah, Mumbo, magic get weak. Who wants to be a pumpkin for the whole game? I want Banjo and Kazooie back. But let's get this next Jiggy here. That was in the eye. And open up World 8. Oh, whoa, get away from me. We need to go on top of the hat so I can land on her nose. Okay. Oh, that was pathetic. Ow! Let's see. No, I can't, flat flip up there because that is too high. Can't make it from there because the bottom part of the hat's kind of too high for me to jump over or double jump. Alrighty. Let's see if I can land on the nose here. Yes! So this rats have the eye here. And you get this Jiggy. Number 8. We're getting close. We only got two more worlds to go. And they're probably the two hardest worlds in the game. Speaking of which, I'm gonna go over there now. And you can tell the water is actually higher than when we came in here because we're swimming. And we can actually go on the go right on the this part up here that we couldn't because the water level was too low. Okay, go all the way over here. And we activate the aqua cauldron that will take us to the to that area right there with the grunty head. The grunty head, I guess. Okay, but anyways, go over to this river box, beak buster it, and we find the second water level switch that'll make the water go up a little bit higher. And actually up to right there where we can actually open up World 8. I'm actually going to go ahead and do that real quick, but I'm not going to end the world in this video. Plus, there's another thing I want to do here. Pinky Barge that. Next picture is right over here. We need... let's see. 12 pieces. That's how many you need. And here is World 8. Rusty Bucket Bay. I'm not going to enter it in this video. But I'm not going to end the video just yet. There's another thing I need to do. I'm actually going to go back through here. Shut up, Grunty! I don't care! I don't care about your big plan. Well, I kinda, cause you're involved in, Banjo's sister Tootie, so... You just made things personal. I guess you could say that. Kidnapping, Banjo's sister, but anyways. go all the way over here, back tap this little gate here. Follow this little tunnel right here. And what the third and final water switch makes it rise to its maximum level. But we got 30 seconds because it'll go back down to the last level, so yeah. But there's something we need to get up there. We need the water level at its maximum. Watch out for that stupid piranha. Where is it? Ah, right up here. There's a little opening right here. Which, it's all the way up here. And you found the third and final Cheeto book. They're very getting good at finding Cheeto, so another spell they shall have. That trainer book has pushed its luck. So in the burning fire of El Chuck. Find Cheeto, which won't. Code you must enter on Sandcastle Floor in Treasure Trove Cove is Gold Feathers. So yeah, we can now enter the Red and Gold Feathers cheats. But I'm actually going to go ahead and stop the video here. So join me next time on Let's Replay Banjo-Kazooie. Well, I will enter those two cheats and enter World 8. This is GeeksBud16 signing off. Later.